Hello, this is a video for Josh Vandermeulen and the continuing series on how to become a millionaire, which is a very fascinating series. In his latest installment, which is episode 2, technically the third video in the series if you count the introduction, he had asked us to do a vid on our financial goals and our background and things like that. I will start with the my current financial goals, and that is to get my debt paid off, which I do have debt. Make no mistake, I do have debt. I'm not some superhuman debt-free maniac, okay? I'm just a regular guy like everybody else. And we managed, the wife and I, we managed to accrue a bit of debt when she was going through school. So we're working on paying that off. So the actual financial goals, my short-term financial goals, are to have $1,000 cash in on hand. Now I'm not going to tell you where I am with that, because that's one of those things that nobody seems to be able to understand. Like, you show them $1,000 cash, they'll just, you can't win when you show something like that. $1,000 cash, and then you pay the cards hard after that. Once we get our plastic and car payments done, we still have about 10 years more on a mortgage. But while we're doing the 10 years more on the mortgage, we'll be building up a 6 to 18 month expense buffer in savings, so that it gives you a little bit more freedom. And the way that we're doing our plastic and other payments is the snowball method, which is you begin paying a certain amount towards your lowest balance debt, and you pay on that, and then once that's paid for, you go to your next lowest, contributing all the money that you would have been putting towards that lower balance onto the other one. Like, you don't adjust your personal budget, okay, after one thing's paid off. You take a certain amount that goes towards debt payment, and it snowballs. So, like, by the time you're paying the last thing, all of the money that you would have been putting towards all the other things is all going towards that. So that is the short-term financial goals that I personally have. Now, if establishing that buffer of savings ends up being $1 million, which it doesn't, then so be it. But, it's obviously to have 18 months of solid expense savings is going to be tens upon tens of dollars. All right, that is so those are my current financial goals. Now, some may wonder, like, okay, well, why don't you make some longer term ones? Well, the thing is, my wife and I, we stress on upward mobility. So, our needs and everything are changing, and we're living and existing in a moment, continuing our educations. We enjoy some of the finer things out there, and that's all factored into what we do. My point at this stage is not to say, okay, well, when I make $1 million, I'm done, I'm all set. That's my end game. That isn't the case for me. If we end up with $1 million in savings, then, so be it. That's not like, I don't believe personally that once you hit a certain amount of money that you cross some sort of threshold that puts you in this position to where you've made it, or you're somehow kicking ass and winning. You don't have to look too hard to find examples of people that manage to waste tens upon tens of million dollars in a year, hundreds of millions of dollars. People have been managed to squander. So it's one of those situations where you can never rest on your laurels. I would like to say that to this point we've made debt work for us, but you have to be extremely careful with that, and it's not a path that I would recommend. Our situation put us into where by the time the wife was done with school, we really needed a different vehicle, and there are other options out there, but we wanted to have something nice, so we did. All right. Now, as far as my background, I had mentioned in the past that we were at the poverty level. Now, let me clarify something like that. Now, I've mentioned that my parents are well-to-do, and that is true. My parents own a great deal of property. My dad has done extremely well for himself, and you may say, well, if that's the case, then you should be all set. No, that's incorrect. Just because my parents are wealthy does not have anything to do with me. Now, remember what I said earlier in this video about how millions of dollars can be squandered in a single year. That is absolutely true. If you need to rely on an inheritance to exist the way that you plan to exist, then it's not going to help you. You don't deserve it, and it will be wasted. Because the inheritance has nothing to do with what you get. You never want to lose sight of your work, time, and effort that the money represents, okay? Money isn't some sort of a mystical genie in a bottle that'll solve all your solutions, because you'll be rubbing on that genie so much, eventually you're out of your three little wishes. Okay? So the idea is to establish the discipline, and you have to get to yourself to the point where the inheritance is kind of irrelevant. I mean, it ends up happening, but it's not something you rely on. I know of several cases where a person had inherited what they saw as being quite a bit of money, say $300,000. Seems like a lot of money, right? That same person was $80,000 in credit card debt. How can that happen? I don't know. More or less, they immediately paid their debts. They got this nice little, what they consider to be a nice little nest egg of inheritance in there. And lo and behold, maybe 5, maybe 6 years down the road, guess what happens? The money's gone, and they're once again in a ridiculous amount of credit card debt. Do you understand why that happened? Does anybody have any question as to why that happened? The $300,000 made really no difference. What it bought 5 years of time, then you had nothing left after that point. It's a rough game. It's a rough game, and it's unforgiving. But it's to coin a metaphor, it's swimming. It's not chilling out in a hot tub, okay? And you're swimming against a current. So, let me close this with a little bit more of what was my personal financial awakening. I want to close out on that, and we'll leave this as it is for now. My personal financial awakening had to do with we were going through a phase where I wasn't making very much money, and that's that poverty level I was telling you about. We had just purchased a house based on the recommendations that everybody had given us. And they recommend you purchase a house that you can't afford because you'll always be making more money, right? That was in 2003. Well, lo and behold, we're using our credit cards for everything, living it up nice, and eventually our credit card payments due ended up being nearly more than what we could afford. And then all of a sudden, these things we wanted, we no longer had the room in our credit cards. And it was like, ooh, what do we do? And somebody had recommend refinancing, which we did. And The refinancing thing, that's going to have to be a video all on its own. But we refinanced our house. And during that refinance, instead of just blindly doing the refinance, more or less rolling all of our credit card debt onto our home equity, there was quite a bit of education involved. Now, I will, that education is going to have to stand as its own particular video, but needless to say, we've only needed to refinance once. So I will get further into that at a later time, and I look forward to the rest of Josh's series. I think it's great what he's doing on here, and I hope that it can make a difference for some people who may not, I don't know. It can be hard. It can be really hard, but there's always hope. You know, there's no permanence in wealth, and there's no permanence in failure. The only time that failure becomes permanent is when you've given up. So, to Josh, great series. To everybody else, I hope you enjoy some. Enjoy, and any questions are more than welcome. And Josh seems like a very amiable person, so you can direct your questions to him as well, I'm sure. So, till next time, until the next vid on this series, we'll take care. Bye.